And really, that's the ultimate Taoist goal, is to go back and discover our former true self, our simple, pure-hearted version of who we were when we were born. Life's experiences mold you and shape you into the person who you become, but through meditation, self-cultivation, mental training, you can return back to the person who you originally were, which is called Shizen in Japanese, aka natural state. And you do that by following what's called the truth and becoming a true man. Abraham Maslow calls this self-actualization, which is actually the true definition of being alpha. People throw that word around, and even I do, as a joke, but when you're truly alpha, whether you're male or female, it's when you become self-actualized. And it takes years for a human male or a human female to get there, unless, of course, you're a prodigy, like Goku. And what's interesting is that this concept is one that was also borrowed by George Lucas in Star Wars, another connection between Star Wars and Dragon Ball, because both Toriyama and George Lucas studied Eastern philosophy, and they understand what all of this means. In Star Wars, you have the Jedi Knights. The Jedi Knights are basically guys who are supposedly pure of heart, clean-minded, and they have no desires or attachments. They're pretty much monks. This is very similar to the Taoist belief of Shiraki. And the only way to achieve this is by letting go of our desires, our needs, and our selfish wants, and detaching ourselves from the world while gaining virtue along the way. Goku is a simple, pure-hearted child who was raised in nature by his grandpa, and thus has no attachment to anything but his grandpa, which, for the first few arcs of Dragon Ball, is a motivating factor for the character. But even as Toriyama continued to tell the story of Dragon Ball and the life of Goku unraveled, Goku was still incorruptible. Goku never went evil, and even though he did do very selfish things, he still was inherently a good person. Remember, just because you're trying to achieve perfection or virtuousness does not mean that you're gonna not slip up a few times. Case in point, we'll take two other characters in Dragon Ball. One is, of course, Goku's best friend, Kudini, who, when we first meet him, he can't even ride the Nimbus Cloud. He can't ride it because he's not pure of heart. He has lustful thoughts. But later in the series, during the battle with Vegeta on Earth, he was able to successfully utilize Goku's Genki-Dama, and it was said that the Genki-Dama can only be used by somebody who has a pure heart. So the idea is that at some point in your life, you may not have a pure heart, but you can attain it, and that seems to be what happened here. Vegeta, speaking of, is the perfect example of somebody like this. Early in the series and throughout his whole life, Vegeta was, let's keep it real, a prick. Because of his upbringing, which I may cover in a future edition of Dragon Ball in depth, Vegeta is a very insecure person, a very flawed person, and when you analyze the times where Vegeta has referred to himself as having a pure heart of evil, like during his fight with 19, you have to understand that that's just a defense mechanism to cover up his insecurities and his jealousy of Goku. However, his heart was definitely dark. Case in point, what happened in the very next arc when he became Majin Vegeta. Madoshi Babidi sensed that Vegeta had evil inside of him, but he wasn't a purely evil person, but he's able to use that evil and unearth that evil and make it kind of come to the forefront. That's what he could do with his warlock powers, and that's how he created Majin Vegeta. And once again, that was based on the jealousy that Vegeta had for Goku after he saw Goku fight Yakun and realized that this dude, again, is still really strong, and Vegeta quite hadn't surpassed him yet. And the issue was that because Vegeta was so selfish and got into a fight with Goku and became Majin Vegeta, this would cause many more problems, such as the birth of Majin Buu. And as a result of that, Vegeta realized that he had committed a very bad act, which is why he sacrificed himself to try to kill Majin Buu, because it was him atoning for his sins. And by the end of the Buu arc, when the God Dragon of Namek resurrects Vegeta and chooses to bring him back to life, even though the wish was made to only bring back good people, that was Vegeta's character arc. He realized at the end of the Buu saga that it was time for him to stop being jealous of Goku and to forget the past, like Kylo Ren said, and focus on the future, and really did the best he could to protect the universe. And as a result of these good deeds, Vegeta that was deemed good by the god dragon of Namek Barunga, which closed the book on his character arc. Now, is Vegeta pure of heart? Difficult to say, but he's definitely not a bad dude anymore, and he's definitely not pure either. So like a lot of things in Dragon Ball, that's pretty much where Toriyama got his idea from, which is old school Eastern philosophy. And I think because of this, a lot of us as fans relate more to Vegeta because our path in life mirrors that of Vegeta. We go through struggles, we have good and bad, and sometimes very bad happen to us, and it makes us a little bit jaded. Goku was a different type of cat. But if you're out there, I want you to really reflect and think about what it is in life that kind of made you do bad things. We all do bad things from time to time. What makes you do that? And try to move past it and try to really find yourself and maybe, you know, come close to achieving this mastery of purity. It's not going to be something that's easy, but I think it's a goal worth achieving. And the idea of us bettering ourselves is one that is the theme of Dragon Ball. Goku wants to fight his opponents. He doesn't want to kill him. He wants to make himself better because of his genes and his biology, but also because he has no ill will toward people, only the ones that hurt his friends or that threaten the sanctity of the universe. Thanks for watching this episode of Dragon Ball In Depth. Hope you got something from it. And remember to keep fighting the good fight in your life. I'll catch you down the road. Thank you.